Welcome everyone, I'm Ricky from Tech Talk. This is the brand new Oppo Reno 2, and today we're going to be taking a look at the accessibility options and settings that we find on this device. I haven't had an Oppo device on the channel before, so this is going to be very interesting as it offers a different level of software, and this is called ColourOS. So hopefully it is the same, but let's delve in and find out. So one thing I just want to highlight before we begin is, sadly, when I first set up the device during my unboxing and setup, there was sadly no options for accessibility features and settings, which is a shame as we see on other devices and from other manufacturers. Also, there was no volume key shortcuts option either, which is a shame. But let's carry on and see what options and settings it does offer now it is set up. So the first option is a volume key shortcut, which is available once the device is set up and turned on for the first time. So to get this activated, you use both the keys on the side here. So I'm pressing and holding them.
Talk back on. TalkBack is a screen reader primarily for people with blindness and low vision. It allows interaction with the device using spoken feedback. TalkBack tutorial.
So this is a tutorial. It's going to move on to the next stage, and then obviously it will go through this for you. So I'm just going to come home.
Button. System launcher. Clock 4 multiply 3. Double tap to activate. Double tap and hold to long press.
So it's given me options here what to do once it's highlighted. And as you can see, this whole area here is highlighted. But then you can go through and touch other areas.
Phone. Messages, Chrome, camera, double tap to activate, double tap and hold to long press.
So it tells you what to do, which is really helpful. And obviously it's very clear and very easy to understand. You can then also do this up at the top.
11:43 status bar item, Wi-Fi signal full, phone signal full, Wi-Fi signal full, screen is locked in portrait orientation, battery, power saving mode is on status bar item, remaining battery 91%.
Going across along the top there, it's really key, so then it highlights different things to you. So you've got your phone's battery percentage, which is really helpful. We've got our Wi-Fi connection and how full that is. Again, our network connection and how full that is. And obviously it will read notifications as well if you just leave it up there at the top, which is amazing. You can then use two fingers to navigate.
Page 3 of 3.
And then obviously
home screen, page 1 of 3. Home screen, page 2 of 3.
So you can navigate and do whatever you need to do. So TalkBack is a great feature. It'll work system-wide, wherever you are and whatever you want to do. To turn this off, press and hold the volume keys together again.
TalkBack off.
There we go. TalkBack is now off, but obviously you can turn this on in the settings that we're going to look at even more now. So to find your accessibility settings, what you need to do is jump into settings option here, which is the gear icon. Swipe all the way down until you find additional settings, which is here. So halfway down, then inside additional settings, again, scroll down, and then you've got accessibility. So before we go through this, again, a little bit of a down point is that it's so hidden. It's in its subsections. It's deep within the settings option. It needs to be brought forward and maybe on the main settings option. I have spoken to senior Oppo team members and also the people that are behind ColourOS 6.1 to explain the situation, to get them to bring it forward, which they should do. And they have taken that on board. And they said they are always working on new settings and new ideas. So they are very grateful for my feedback and they will take it on board. And hopefully in the next update, we should see that come forward. And we'll keep an eye out for that as well. So now we're finally into our accessibility settings. Let's go through the different options that we find here. So first of all, you have accessibility shortcuts. Like I said, this needs to be turned on initially before you can use the volume key shortcut I showed you straight away. So also you can change the different options inside here. So it's preset to talk back. You have accessibility menu, select to speak, and then switch access depending on which options you want to use. Really grateful to see that. Then also available on the lock screen as well. You can toggle that on or off depending on your choice. Underneath that is accessibility menu. So toggle this on. So once toggled on, you'll see your little accessibility man down here at the bottom. You've now got four icons along the bottom. Press this. Then you have a range of different options inside here to choose from in the accessibility section. So that's always going to be on your home screen. So if we go home here, tap here, then you've got different options to choose and use straight away instead of going through all the settings process, which I think is really a good option to have. So underneath that is an option called select to speak. So select to speak is slightly different to TalkBack in the way it works. So let's toggle it on. So once toggled on, your little accessibility man is going to come back again. He's always going to be appearing. So if we press him here, and then actually it's going to give us the option what we want to do. So do we want to go to the accessibility menu or do we want to use select to speak, which is really helpful. We're going to select the select to speak. So let's press him again. You'll notice this play, pause or stop button comes up. Let's press play.
Select to speak. When select to speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them aloud. First, tap the icon. Then you can tap a specific item, like text or an image. Drag your finger across the screen to select multiple items. Tap the play button to hear everything on screen. Settings. Navigate up. Select to speak.
So it goes through everything for you. There's also another option here. So if I actually bring this up again and then press here, it will start here instead of starting at the top.
When select to speak is on, you can tap specific items on your screen to hear them aloud.
So it started here instead of starting up here. It's a great option to use if you want to quickly jump in and actually hear something read back to you or narrated to you. So say you use it in a news article or you wanted to read a website. You didn't want to read everything, whereas TalkBack will read everything, but you wanted to read the main bulk of that website or the main bulk of that news article. This is the option for you. A really good feature to actually use here. So press stop, that will dismiss. And again, you can toggle that on or off depending on your choice. And again, if you have an accessibility menu on, that's still going to stay here as well. I believe your new accessibility little friend here is going to be there. It'll become your new best friend to help you out. So underneath that is TalkBack. So TalkBack is on here. And again, you have the different options to use TalkBack. There is a settings option here in settings. You're going to notice this with some accessibility options. You're going to have settings. And again, this means you can go more in depth and actually delve in and have a look what options are available. And on the channel, we are going to soon have an in-depth look at every accessibility setting. So a real harsh in-depth look to see what options are available. Whereas this is just a quick overview of the actual settings that are available on your device. So coming back. So underneath that, you then have text-to-speech output. So text-to-speech output is a great setting that you can change and adjust the speech rate and also the pitch. So you can go really fast.
This is an example of speech that's English.
Which is really fast. We can actually make it really slow.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
And then obviously you can reset and obviously you can change your pitch as well.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
And then you can go really deep.
This is an example of speech synthesis in English.
Just depends what option you need to change to and what's best for you. But it's nice to have that option on there, I believe. Underneath that is magnification gestures. So go in here, toggle this on. Three quick taps will actually zoom in for you. And here's our text. You can then pinch to zoom in and out, depending which you want to do. Use two fingers to manipulate your way around this device. And thanks to it having a pivot rising camera up here at the top, you actually don't have a notch in your way or interrupting you no matter what you want to do. Again, this will work system wide wherever you are on your device and very easy to actually turn on or off. 1, 2, 3 will bring you back. There's also another option as well. So 1, 2, 3, hold on your third tap so you don't lift your finger up. And then you actually sort of zoom around with one finger here. Remove it and it goes back to what it originally started as. So turn that off there. That's another great option to use. Underneath that is something called a large mouse pointer. So if you want to use a mouse or an interaction device with your smartphone, you can do, and you have the option there of a large mouse pointer. One great option I really do like underneath that is something called switch access. So switch access gives you the ability to use switches and interaction controls with your smartphone. So if you can't use your hands or your fingers to manipulate your device, you can use switches and interaction devices to do so, which is amazing. Obviously, you have a deep settings menu inside here as well. You can go through, change and adjust depending on your choice and what switches and which interaction devices you use. But it's so impressive that they have this on here. Again, we will be doing a very in-depth video on this setting on the channel, so I will link that down below once that's live. Also, once you select this and turned it on, it will help you go through the setup process. Underneath that, you've got click when the pointer stops moving. So if you had a large mouse pointer, like we've previously gone through, this option will also help you as well. So if you're gonna use a mouse pointer or use a mouse device with your phone, this is what options you will need to change and use. So going inside here, again, you can change the time scale. Underneath that, you've got the power button will end call. So if you look down the right-hand side, so we've got it in the case, but if you take it outside of the case, there is a green button, and I'll showcase that in this video. There's a green button to show which is your power button, which is really impressive to notice. And it's good that they've added that feature in. So you could use that to end your calls. Underneath that, you've got touch and hold delay, and you've got three different options here. So you've got short, medium, and long. So it depends which option best suits your ability. Underneath that, you have mono audio. So you have the ability to use mono audio if you want to. Then finally, you've got subtitles. So once toggled on, so if we toggle it on, you can change the language. So multiple different ranges of languages. You can change the text size. Again, few options here, nice to see. Then also the subtitle style. Again, different options to actually see. And again, you can go through these and change adjust which one best suits you. So that's all the settings you're going to find in the accessibility options here, but there are some more in different sections. So if we come back here and then obviously go back to the main menu, then obviously you can go then to display, which is this orange one here. You can always search for these features as well. If you need to search for them, please do so, and you can. So one thing I do want to talk about is the brightness, a very bright device here, which is awesome. I do like that, with a nice brightness, and it does work really well in the sunlight. You also have automatic brightness as well. Underneath that, you have screen color temperature, so you can have cooler, you can have, and then obviously warmer as well. Just depends what options you want to choose. Coming down a little bit further, you've got font size. So finally, a little bit of an accessibility option here is font size. So nice and easier for me to read, especially when I'm reading through the actual video here. Also, you've got display size. Again, you've got a preset at the top there. And because I've changed the font size, it's automatically changed it to larger, which is helpful. Finally, the Oppo Reno 2 and ColourOS is actually helping me here best suit my needs. You have full screen display. So this is great for when you're using certain applications. You want all of the screen to be shown. You don't want these windows. And obviously with no notch, you're not going to be interrupted as well. Once you started using applications, that will fill up even more. So coming up underneath that is something called Night Shield. So let's go inside here. Let's enable it now. So you have different options as well. So you can change and adjust this depending on your choice, which is really helpful. So coming down underneath that, you have different options. You've got display in color, display in black and white. So obviously it changes it back to white. Or at the bottom, you've got comfortable nighttime reading. So it depends what you want to do with your device. And if I toggle this off here, you'll notice it'll go back to normal. And obviously this gets rid of that harsh blue light that affects your eyesight when actually trying to read your device or look at your device late at night and you're trying to get to sleep. I do recommend that you turn this on. Obviously you can schedule it on and off here. That's a really good helpful thing. Then underneath you've got low brightness and flicker free eye care. So toggle this on, and again, this will change and adjust your device just depending whenever you're using it, and obviously looks after your eye care, which is really important. And as you know, being visually impaired, that's really important to me. And finally at the bottom here, you've got screen color mode. So a couple of different options. You've got vivid or gentle. Again, you'll see it slightly changes. I'm going to keep it vivid. I like vivid. So coming back, that's all of the settings. So let's go back home here. We're back on our home screen. So there is an improvement from previous ColourOS's and the Oppo Reno 1, which I only looked at the launch. Didn't sadly get one on the channel. There are improvements. There's always room, though, for more improvements, especially one is the having the accessibility settings on the setup phase of your device. That needs to happen as soon as possible. Even if it is the volume key shortcut that starts TalkBack, then you can narrate your way through your setup phase. I really hope Oppo work with Android to bring that into the setup phase. Obviously, in the accessibility settings that are on the device, that's really good. There is a massive improvement from the previous one that I previously looked at. There's always room for improvement, bringing new settings, new options that we've seen on other smartphones from other manufacturers and other UI softwares that we've seen that other manufacturers use. But Oppo are doing a great job here. The Reno 2 is available now. I have done an unboxing and first look. So if you want to know more specs, more information on the phone, please go and watch that. The link will be in the description. But of course, if you have any questions or any queries you want to ask me about this device, about the accessibility settings and features, you know what to do. Leave a comment down below and I'll be more than happy to help. While you do that, please like and also subscribe to Tech Talk UK 1. Stay updated with all of the latest news, reviews and unboxings from me, Ricky. I will see you really soon. Bye for now.